It's been several weeks now since we freed the Mohawk prisoners from captivity. I had hoped their leader might make contact, but there's been only silence. My men grow restless. They want to know what comes next, and I do not have an answer. Lee alone remains active, pursuing leads, however slight. He stalks the city streets and scouts the bordering woods, hopeful that he might make contact with one of those we saved. There was a woman there that night. It was she who helped the others to safety. If we can find her, I believe I'll have my answers. So, I watch and wait, hopeful that my true mission might finally begin. Charles, any luck finding our mystery woman?
Word is she's been stirring up trouble just outside the city in a town called Lexington.
Well, then that's where we begin our search. I'll meet you there.
General Edward Braddock leads 2,000 men.
Have you found her?
She's made camp not too far from here.
Excellent. Well, the sooner we're done, the sooner we can get out of this cold.
We'll move faster on horse. I am afraid I have some bad news, sir.
Oh?
Braddock is insisting I return to service under him. I've tried to beg off, to no avail.
No doubt he's still angry about losing Pitcairn. Say nothing of the shaming we gave him. Do as he asks. In the meantime, I'll work on having you released.
I'm sorry for the trouble.
Not your fault.
We're too late.
Fire's only just been snuffed. Snow recently disturbed. She's close.
Bollocks.
These tracks are fresh. They must be hers. Seems she took to higher ground. Out of the snow and into the trees. Wait here.
Back! You return to Braddock, Charles, before he grows suspicious. I can handle things from here.
But, sir!
But nothing! Go! Stop running! I only wish to talk! I am not your enemy! Please just hear me out! Gods, woman! Only let me speak! Enough!
Try my patience, woman!
Are you touched in the head?
Me, Haytham. I come in peace.
Why are you speaking so slow?
Sorry.
What do you want?
Well, your name, for one.
I'm Gudzidzio.
Pleased to meet you. Gudzidzio.
Just call me Zio.
Dio.
Zio.
Dio.
Well, tell me why it is you're here. Where did you get this?
From an old friend.
I've only seen such markings in one other place.
Where?
Well, it is forbidden for me to speak of it.
I saved your people. Does this mean nothing to you?
Look, I am not the enemy.
Close to here, there is a hill. Meet me there, and we'll see if you speak the truth. That town hosts soldiers who seek to drive my people from these lands. They're led by a man known as the Bulldog.
Edward Braddock.
You know him?
He is no friend of mine.
Every day, more of my people are lost to men like him.
Then I suggest we put a stop to it. Together.
What do you propose?
That we kill Edward Braddock. But first, we have to find him.
Thank you.
I don't trust you.
I know.
Yet you remain.
But I might prove you wrong.
It will not happen.
So you say.
So I know.
Yet, I remain. Wait here. A Mohawkman is likely to raise suspicions, if not muskets.
This is hardly the first time I've been amongst your people. I can handle myself.
I hope so.
Can't stand being quartered there. The endless crashing of the waves, the sting of the salt in my eyes, and the goddamn gulls shrieking and shitting everywhere.
You're sure that's where we're going?
Aye. The Bulldog's putting together another expedition.
That's what they're calling them now. Expeditions.
Aye. Smart, too. Slap a fancy name on something and all evil is excused.
I hear tell the French are readying to move on our positions. Wonder what Braddock intends to do about it.
He's already left for the advance camp. I'll wager our little holiday here is just about ended. We'll be marching south before week's end.
What's the go on a good
hour? Oi! Where are you going, Cully?
Me?
No, the other cock robin.
Well, I was leaving.
Oh? And now?
Well, now, I'm going to feed you your teeth.
And you were worried I was going to be the problem? You're hurt.
Oh, it's nothing.
Here. This should stop the bleeding.
That wasn't necessary. But thank you.
We should move on. Meet me at Braddock's camp when you're ready. Use the snowstorm to mask your approach. Having second thoughts?
Hardly. But I'll have to approach this carefully.
Go on, then. I'll keep watch from here.
I can hide in that cart.
Full inventory.
As you wish. Let's see. 2 barrels of salt, 12 pounds of pork, 10 pounds of beef, 7 dozen eggs, 16 wheels of cheese, none of it French, don't worry, 5 bottles of whiskey, a couple dozen new uniforms, boots, and leather for patching, blankets, a cart feed for the horses. What else? That's it. That's all there is.
Those cannons are like to cause trouble. Perhaps I could sabotage them. Those cannons are like to cause trouble. Perhaps I could sabotage them.
A diplomatic solution was no solution at all. That allowing the French to retreat would only delay an inevitable conflict, one in which they'd now have the upper hand.
There's merit to those words, as much as I hate to admit it. Still, can't he see this is unwise?
It doesn't sit well with me either. We're far from home with our forces divided. Worse, I fear Braddock's bloodlust makes him careless. It puts the men at risk. I'd rather not be delivering grim news to mothers and widows because the Bulldog wanted to prove a point.
Where is the General now?
Rallying the troops.
And then it's on to Fort Duquesne, I assume?
Eventually. The march north will surely take time. There's a copy of the plans in the command tent should you wish to review them.
At least this will be ended soon.
I tried, John.
I know, my friend. I know.
That map will surely be of use. I need to find it. Those cannons are like to cause trouble. Perhaps I could sabotage them.
What news?
Braddock has left to rally his troops. They're marching on Fort Duquesne. It'll be a while yet till they're ready, which gives us time to form a plan.
No need. We will ambush him here near the river. Go and gather your allies. I will do the same. I will send word when it is time to strike.